rut. You say, wow, what are we going to do next?
Or well, every time, that's the funny thing about the songwriting in Coach Club is everybody's got so many ideas. It's a case of not sitting there thinking, how are we going to write the next Karma Chameleon? It's a case of, you shut up, I've got an idea, you shut up, that's me, you know.
Also,
because,
like that, you know. I mean, you do, every time you write a hit song, you think, like when I write songs, I think, oh my God, I'll never write another one. And I seize that for 6 months and then I'll write like 1,000 songs. That's, you know, like John says, with their second album, Colour by Numbers, we argued for 6 months, we wrote the album in 10 days. That's, you know, productive argument.
Is there any pressure on you to come up with another top 10 record, or you just go out and make it?
No,
and
say, if you think that way, I think that's like saying, you know, have a formula. Mm-hmm. I think you just do what you want to do, and then it's like every single we release is a new single for us. We don't worry. Once it's out in the shops, that's it, you forget about it.
Right.
It's like bands often go back and remix things they did a year ago. That to me is like madness.
Right.
When it's done, it's finished.
How do you guys feel about it when somebody takes one of your songs and remixes it and makes it sound totally different?
Well, I like that.
It's okay. I mean, they don't do it on a large commercial scale. I mean, if it's very interesting. If somebody just took a record for some reason.
There's a reggae version of Karma Chameleon, which we love. Mm-hmm. And there's also a Japanese version of Do You Really Wanna Hurt Me, which was like big in LA last year.
There was a Finnish version as well from Finland.
We love
very
it.
Very strange.
I think it's a compliment. That anybody should want to take your song and make it, you know, make it theirs. I think it's great.
Yeah.
You know, Frank Sinatra stepped out on the board and did one of my songs. I'd be standing on my head.
Hallelujah. What about your involvement in your videos? Are you guys like heavily involved in the directing and
now.
The ideas kind of?
Well, it's a funny story.
Don't ask. George used to be involved with the videos at the start. And so the thing was, George has lots of ideas, and the directors weren't getting his ideas right. So we all thought
it was him, right?
So we're going, listen, George, you know, stop getting involved in these videos, let the directors do it. So he went, all right, you know, great reluctance. But what happened was, the ones, even when the directors started, weren't right. So George has gone back, and now we've got some different directors who we all get really on well with, and George's like ideas are coming out now.
If there was one thought that you wanted to leave the audience with, all right, what would that thought be? What would Culture Club like to convey to the audience?
And that was worth every penny. That's the thought. And also, it says in the tour program, kick a critic.
Kick a critic? Well, I'm not a critic.
No, what I say is that, you know, like after four numbers, the only people sitting down are the press.
Buy the t-shirts.
Well, those who bought too much shopping with them.
Well, listen, you guys are crazy. It was great having you on the show. And, continue success, really, and stay unique.
Thank you.
And thank you for coming on Hot Tracks. Culture Club on Hot Tracks.
Thank you.